between Ronaldo Souza and Stefan Struve. So this young fighter making the walk here tonight, and he's a very entertaining fighter. He's very adept at staying in the pocket while avoiding significant damage coming back. Certainly, he's made a career of frustrating opponents, stays relaxed in there, leans on the defense, and uses that defensive movement to set up his own offense. You'll see him move that head off of the center line, counter beautifully, really more of a counter-striker offensively. But his defense will wow you, even when the opposition feels like they have him in range. More often than not, they miss and land less than 25% of their significant strike attempts. So here is the ex-gym product, Ronaldo Chacaré Souza, a guy who many believe right now at present is the best middleweight in the world. For much of his UFC career, he has been on the brink of a UFC title shot. Perhaps there is one coming down the pipe, but you can be sure when it does, Chacaré Souza will likely be favored by oddsmakers to win that UFC middleweight championship.
This guy is one of the toughest guys I have ever seen inside the octagon. His ability to absorb punishment and then come back from it is just absolutely incredible to watch.
Our tale of the tape for this, our main event of the evening. Souza is 9 years the elder. Struve weighed in at 265 pounds. He will have a 12-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the official introductions, the veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon is Herb D. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City. Jiu-Jitsu fighter, holding professional record of 25 wins, 6 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Ronaldo Chacaré Souza!
Beginning your stretches in the dressing room, practice up.
All right, here we go. I am fired up for this fight. It's been a long time coming, and they're finally gonna get after it.
All right, so this UFC Grand Prix tournament is coming up next. This format has been all the rage with a lot of the hardcore mixed martial arts fans out there. Sort of an homage to the history of UFC and Pride with a single night tournament game event here. And let's see who can be the last man standing here tonight.
Clean punch.
Trying to establish that jab once again. Oh, beautiful kick to the body there, and he just left himself wide open for that strike. Very vulnerable by leaning in, keeping the guard high to allow for an opening down low.
Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy.
Oh, he's got the arm, Joe. Trying to set up an arm bar here.
got the arm here. Now he's going to throw his leg over. And he got his arm loose.
Nice punch by Shaka Souza there.
He takes the back. Excellent movement here on the ground.
Just over 3 minutes to go now.
Very nice sweep, winds up in his opponent's guard. Perfectly timed sweep. Hits the reversal here and in the full guard. Excellent posture here.
Oh, nice punch there by Shaka Souza there.
Back to full guard.
Wow.
Looking to secure a choke. He's looking for a guillotine choke. He's in full guard here. What he needs to do to get the guillotine is first, he's got to throw his arm over the back of his opponent's head. Then he's got to slide his forearm. That's it!
There it is!
He got the choke for the tap.
Well, yeah, Joe, he told us during fight week he's been working dutifully on his submission game and he was going to look for an opening here tonight. Safe to say he found one. Near-perfect setup on the choke. It was sunk in deep, and his opponent had no choice but to tap out or go to sleep.
And here we can see it again. That's a real tight choke here. And let's watch it here one more time. Deep submission and the tap.
So a seminal moment for this fighter here tonight as he gets the win by submission. Huge victory in his career, and it'll be very interesting to see how they matchmake him moving forward.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop for this contest at 3 minutes, 24 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by tap out due to a guillotine choke, Stefan Strykowski.
Well, what a submission win for this oncoming force here tonight. I think he's going to be a problem for a lot of fighters in this division. Tonight, though, is all about the celebration after getting the finish that he so sought coming in here tonight. You see how happy his coaches are, his training partners. This is going to be a fun night for this team and one that they have richly deserved.